Health and Tech has a new partnership that involves blockchain technology. With me is the CEO, Tim Johnson of Health and Tech. To talk about this partnership, let's start with the basics. Who is it with? And just tell me that, and then we'll go into what exactly it means for the company.
Sure. We've recently entered into a letter of intent, a non-binding letter of intent with AlphaTON. AlphaTON is a relatively new company created by Brittany Kaiser, a very well-known cybersecurity individual in the space. A few people that understand blockchain extremely well. And that partnership between our knowledge base on the healthcare side, how claims, how underwriting, and how all that works, we're going to take that knowledge to try to improve through the use of the blockchain, how to improve claims handling. Claims handling is a $300 billion problem in the healthcare market. You have errors, no transparency, security issues, all of those things that all of those current problems that we have with claims handling in the healthcare side can, in my opinion, can be solved through a proper use of a built blockchain.
Well, yeah, I mean, because blockchain kind of fits into that nicely. You can't tamper with it. You know, it's based on, you know, technology, so you'll be able to have a record of it that way. So explain, like, exactly what this means for the consumer. Like, how will they benefit from this?
Excellent question. So when Bill Clinton signed into law HIPAA, the P in HIPAA has never been solved. And in my opinion, it was the most important for the consumer, as you alluded to. The consumer ability to create portability with their owned, their medical records, their PHI information, personal health information. It was a good idea to create it because, again, legally, individuals do own their information. But there was no way to control it, no way to manage it. Where do I put it? All of the handling of it. This particular program that we're working on, and I've been trying to work on this. I wrote a paper in 2019 on this, but the technology wasn't there quite yet. They did have blockchain, but they didn't have some of the things sorted out, and there weren't that many experts in it. Over the last 6 years, it has gotten to the point now where there's a lot of people that understand it. The technology has improved such that we can create these wallets, and every individual that is on the blockchain will have their own secure, because the blockchain's the most secure, they'll have their own secure medical information, and they can take that with them wherever they go and share it with the people that they need to share it with. If they have a doctor, if they're traveling, they have a doctor, they can share it with them, and that doctor can open it up and see everything going on.
Oh, wow. That sounds fascinating because, you know, now if you go to get something done and you go to a new doctor, they need to contact the other. This way, the patient has the data, which is one of the great promises of blockchain. What about in terms of your business? Do you see this being an addition to revenue or streamline operations? How will it impact Health and Tech?
Yeah. So the idea I had back in 2019 was that all of the, there's a long, you know, coincidentally, there's a chain, right? In the blockchain, in the chain of healthcare, there are a lot of vendors. There are a lot of vendors that create an administrative cost. A lot of those vendors will be, I don't want to say they're going to be replaced, but their positions will be changed dramatically. And we will benefit from everybody coming to our chain. We call it HIT chain. To our chain to participate in the process. We're really going to make everybody's lives easier. The one thing that this really does, in my opinion, is it creates a win-win for everybody. The problem is adoption, because you are dealing with, we want to use stable coins. You know, it transitions to the dollar really well. So, and it's very quick. So that electronic exchange of money. So hospitals get paid quicker, vendors get paid quicker, but the amount of money flowing through the system, and it costs money to send money back and forth in time. We can eliminate all of that. And we want to participate in the middle of that. So people come to us and it will create, we'll have revenue in there where we'll take a piece of the transactions, but we want to solve that issue. This thing solves transparency, security, compliance, audits, efficiency, portability, as I said, so many different things on the chain. But I was reading an article this morning and written about it. And the gentleman is correct that wrote the article. It is a big idea with a lot of effort in it. So it's going to take definite due diligence to build it. And So we're up for the challenge. We're in a unique position to understand it.
And you've got to start somewhere, right? I mean, to build out these big systems and its structures, you got to start. Okay, so then, Tim, so what's next? Like, you got this LOI, this letter of intent, and then what happens next? When do you think we may actually be able to benefit from this technology?
So the idea and the timeline, we're going to get together with AlphaTON. This happened very quickly because AlphaTON is a relatively new company. They are still going through their transition of what they look like on their internal relations, their platforms and everything. We're going to meet with them within the next week or two to sit down to put together a contract, get all the arrangements built out. And then they have a very good group of developers. The development process, it comes in tranches. So every quarter, we ought to be able to roll something out that says, look at what we're doing here. I'm not sure if we can roll something out and have people participating in it within the next, say, 6 months, or we have to get it all put together yet. That's still to be determined.
Yeah. Well, it sounds fascinating. And I hope that you will come back as you kind of slowly unveil this technology and how it's impacting your business and come back and talk to us about it and how people can participate.
I would love to.
Yeah. Thanks so much, Tim.